Global climate change, mainly due to greenhouse gas emissions, is causing average temperatures to rise around the world in what seems to be a global warming. However, over the course of the 20th century, summer temperatures in the Midwestern United States actually became cooler, bucking the global trend. During the same period, significant changes in land use and land cover were documented in many regions, including the Midwestern United States, which experienced unprecedented increases in agricultural productivity. In this study, researchers set out to determine whether this agricultural intensification was responsible for observed trends of decreased temperatures and associated increases in humidity and rainfall. The researchers analyzed historical weather data and found that the most significant changes in the Midwestern climate were centered on the period of 1950 to 1970. After this period, summers tended to be cooler, more humid, and with more rainfall. Historical agricultural data also revealed that production of key crops, including corn and soybeans, began increasing dramatically during the period of 1950 to 1970. Increased irrigation, fertilizer application, and a host of other factors led to much more of these crops being produced in the Midwest every summer. While the changes in both agricultural production and climate are clearly correlated in space and time, this is not enough to conclude that one caused the other. To test this hypothesis, the researchers conducted an ensemble of simulations using the MIT Regional Climate Model. In the experimental set of simulations, the historical increase in crop productivity was approximated by increasing the rate of photosynthesis in the simulated crops by a factor of 6, while photosynthesis was unchanged in the control set. The results showed local decreases in temperature and increases in humidity and rainfall that were similar to the trends observed in the historical data. To check whether or not these changes were caused by increases in greenhouse gas emissions, the results of simulations from several other climate models that include the increase in greenhouse gas concentrations but do not account for changes in land use were analyzed. The results from these simulations showed warming instead of cooling and small rainfall changes instead of rainfall enhancement, neither of which match historical observations. This suggests that greenhouse gas emissions alone do not explain the observed changes in Midwestern summer climate. Why then should increases in crop production lead to cooler, wetter conditions? When plants grow through photosynthesis, water is released from their leaves in a process known as transpiration. More transpiration releases more water into the atmosphere, increasing humidity and lowering temperature. The researchers calculated that these effects create a local increase in what is known as moist static energy, which can lead to increased rainfall. Additionally, the increase in water vapor could simply be falling back out as rain in nearby areas. As the dangers of greenhouse gas emissions are becoming clearer, it's important to understand that other human-caused changes also affect the climate. Increasing plant growth, specifically in the form of intensive agriculture, may have led to the Midwestern United States becoming cooler and wetter during the 20th century, and may have masked warmer temperatures that would have otherwise resulted from increasing greenhouse gas emissions. This finding underscores the importance of taking land use changes into account when modeling climate change, and also helps to inform strategies for how we can best adapt to climate change and mitigate its worst effects.